report, an out of the Bundaberg heartbreak, an inspiring story of a local SES leader who's helping others even though her own home is flooded. Cathy Border reports on the woman who lost her home but not her fighting spirit.
From the skies where the deluge came, the size of Bundaberg's flood disaster is graphically clear.
It's staggering.
Waters surging, the impact obvious.
There's going to be a lot of work to be done here.
Bundaberg is the focus of our efforts.
Disaster managers briefing the Premier.
A priority in sewage once the waters go down is to get those major pumping stations operational.
If there's anywhere that true Bundaberg fighting spirit is coming through, it's here. Do you believe it? Water Street. The residents have shown their true resilience as the Premier toured here today. And even time for a little cheekiness.
You want to buy a house? Water views?
Yeah. Water views.
Yeah. Water front acreage. On Water
Street. So where are you staying at the moment?
My ex-husband's.
Jill's house, like so many, simply swamped.
So this is your house?
This is mine.
The SES leader's strength shining through.
I'd offer you a cup of tea or coffee, but I don't think I can get in. And I lost Mum 6 months ago, and her wedding ring and engagement ring's in there somewhere, so I'll be going through the slosh looking for that.
She helped others despite her own loss.
I have to keep moving on and help those that you can.
We could move on, but for Jill, the fight back's ahead.
She is just one of the great examples of selflessness during this flood emergency here in Bundaberg.
Jill Hall, you're inspiring.
We are a tough mob, got a lot of guts.
In Bundaberg, Cathy Border, 10 News.